If you've been watching Collector's Confessions for any length of time, you know that we are Flash fans. Me more so than Brian.
Much more.
Mm-hmm. At some point in the future, we will have a video on the Flash movie because someone didn't see it yet.
I haven't seen Spider-Man yet.
Yeah, I know. I don't even want to hear that. And we will be showing my Flash collection at some point once I straighten it up down here. It is immense.
It really is.
It really is immense.
Yeah.
Many of you may have become Flash fans based on the recent Flash series that is ending soon. And some of you may not be aware that there was actually a previous series in 1990 that aired on CBS. And it was only 2 seasons long, if I remember correctly. No, 1 season long. Only aired for 1 season.
I didn't know it was only 1 season.
Only aired for 1 season. It was groundbreaking.
It jumped off from the popularity of the 89 Batman, of course.
Yeah. It was simply titled The Flash, and it was a live-action show based on the comic book character Barry Allen. So they're looking at the Barry Allen Flash, even though at the time it aired, Barry Allen was dead in the comics, and Wally West was the Scarlet Speedster at the time.
Yeah.
It aired from 1990 to 1991, and it starred John Wesley Shipp as Barry Allen the Flash.
Be thankful you're not in Central City.
How many times do I have to kill you?
The Flash.
Let's look at some key details about the series. John Wesley Shipp portrayed Barry Allen with charm and conviction.
Mm-hmm. He's very charming.
He was a very charming guy.
Yeah.
I've met him once or twice over the years.
Mm-hmm.
Capturing the character's intelligence and determination. Shipp's portrayal became a fan favorite. People who like The Flash love John Wesley Shipp.
Mm-hmm.
And he brought a sense of humanity to the Scarlet Speedster. From his chemistry with Amanda Pays, she played Tina McGee, which was a character created for the series, to his confrontations with his best villain on the show, Mark Hamill's Trickster.
So good.
If you haven't seen the series, check out one of the episodes where he fights the Trickster. Mark Hamill was amazing as the villain.
It was his best villain portrayal.
The Joker.
I would say the Cockknocker.
The Cockknocker and James Allen Bob. I have to put a picture of the Cockknocker here because you mentioned it. But Shipp's acting and his portrayal of the character really is what elevated the show. He was probably the best part of the show, was him as Barry Allen.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. In the show.
Yeah. Because, again, I'm just going to chime in as someone who's a much more casual Flash fan. The Flash isn't a character that a lot of people usually go, oh, cool, Flash. It's a small, very devoted fan base, right?
Right.
And this really kind of raised the profile of the character at a weird time for the character when, like, the main guy, Barry Allen, wasn't even the Flash in the comics.
Which was, it was very strange to me as a kid watching the show.
Yeah.
I was a little bit older.
Yeah.
That he was the Flash, and the Flash hadn't been in comic books for years.
85.
So he hadn't been in comics for like 5 years. He was gone, and he was the main character here.
Yeah.
So it became like an alternate reality thing, how multiversity kind of stuff.
Multiverse.
So the plot of the show. The series followed Barry Allen, a forensic scientist, same as the comic books, in Central City. Same as the comic books, who gained superhuman speed after being struck by lightning and doused with chemicals.
Yeah. That happened to me, you know.
Yeah.
I didn't get super fast.
You're not super fast.
It just really hurt. And I lost all my hair.
Burned your skin. That's how that happened. Using his newfound powers, he becomes a superhero named The Flash and fights crime throughout the city. The main antagonist of the series is the criminal called The Trickster, played by legendary actor Mark Hamill. The first and only season of the series consisted of 22 episodes. Each episode focused on a different villain from Flash's Rogues Gallery. If you haven't watched it already, please watch our video from a couple of weeks ago where we look at the top 10 villains of The Flash. And the storyline in the series somehow had like a lesson to be learned, and it connected Barry Allen's personal life with The Flash's fighting of a crime. And throughout the 22 episodes, he develops a relationship with his coworker, who is played again by Amanda Pays, Tina McGee.
Mm. Not all that different from the CW show, actually.
Not
structure.
Not yeah. very mm-hmm. different at all.
Yeah.
And I don't think there's a CW show without this show.
No.
Pairing.
No.
While the series aired in the 1990s, again, we're looking back in time, as we mm-hmm. often do, because we are YouTube's only pop culture archaeologists. Thank you. The action and special effects in the series were impressive for the early 1990s. The Flash's super speed was brought to life with well-executed practical effects
mm-hmm.
and clever camera tricks.
Yeah, CGI effects would have been way too expensive.
Way too expensive for a TV show.
Yeah.
For a fledgling TV show.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. The viewers were thrilled by these special effects.
Mm-hmm.
What's a superhero without their rose gallery? The 1990 Flash series had its fair share of memorable villains. As we said, the Trickster was unbelievable. There was also Captain Cold. There was also Heatwave. There were a host of his... Grodd was not on the show.
I was going to ask.
He was not. Mm. There was a host of his rogues. So if you know the Flash rogues, and there were some characters made up for the series, but they mm-hmm. did look at the characters from the comics, so the villains from the comics. If you are a fan of superhero TV shows, then you know that many TV shows that were made prior to The Flash did not include any of the villains from the comics. The Incredible Hulk. We never saw a Hulk villain from the comic books in it.
Nope. Yeah.
Batman did it perfectly. The Superman series, we never saw her.
No, there was no super
villains. There was no super. He fought gangsters. He fought criminals. Never fought super villains.
Mm-hmm.
Batman was the first one to do it. He stopped. His show ended in the 60s. Mm-hmm. We didn't see another show with real villains until the 1990 Flash. Wonder Woman never fought a villain. It was always these, like, human criminals.
Masterminds, yeah.
They never fought anyone super powerful.
Right, they tried to ground it more in reality.
Yeah.
And I always wondered if that has something to do with licensing costs. Like, did they have the license per character?
Maybe.
It could be.
And back then, when you had Marvel shows and DC shows, they weren't owned by Marvel and DC.
No, they were...
They were licensed to CBS or licensed to...
Right.
I don't know who did... Batman was ABC, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, I think it was.
Before my time.
Mm.
We also saw the Mirror Master. I know that's your favorite, too.
I love Mirror Master,
He was also on a show.
Mm-hmm.
So the show really introduced the world to some of his villains for the first time, because The Flash hadn't really appeared much in any kind of form.
Not really.
On television or in movies. The first time we see him is in the 1960s animated series.
Mm-hmm.
He's not a big part of the Super Friends till later on the cartoon.
Yeah.
He did appear in the... It was a two-episode special called The Legends of the Superheroes.
That's a weird one.
If you've never seen it before, I highly recommend seeing it. It is similar to the Batman series. The basis is on the Batman series, but it's really just kind of goofy.
It's really Legends of the Superheroes! For centuries, the world has been protected by a group of extraordinary men and women who have dedicated themselves to fighting crime. Ladies and gentlemen, the world's mightiest mortal, Superman! The wisdom, strength, and courage of the gods, Captain Marvel fights a never-ending battle against evil. Guardian of the universe and protector of an incredible power ring, the Green Lantern has the ability to perform amazing feats against evildoers. Sentinel of the skies, Winged Phantom of the night, the Hawkman fights the evils of the present with the weapons of the past. Combining beauty, wisdom, and physical prowess, the Huntress fights a constant battle against crime and injustice. Joy of the oppressed, wonder of the multitude, the Flash! The Flying Fighter is swifter than the speed of light, quicker than the rapidest of thought. With the uncanny ability to generate earth-shattering sound waves, the Black Canary fights a relentless battle against criminal injustice. With his endless wind, devil may care, courage, and incredible gymnastic skills, Robin, the Boy Wonder, is Batman's crime-fighting companion. His symbol of lightning, creature of the night, his disguise strikes terror into the criminal heart. Batman, the Caped Crusader, has pledged his life to fighting the forces of evil.
Yeah, it's a 1970s special, and if you grew up in the '70s, you know what we're talking about. These specials were
TV specials.
Yeah. Think about the Star Wars holiday special. This is on par with the Star Wars
Charles
holiday
Nelson
special.
Riley's Halloween specials.
Charles Nelson Riley's Halloween. Mm-hmm. I actually had this on a bootleg video when I was in my teenage years because it only aired once.
Yeah.
And then the only way it was never released on VHS, I had a bootleg copy. It's actually, I think it's on DVD now. They actually released it at some point in recent years.
Yeah.
So he didn't really, the Flash didn't really appear a lot. This was the first time where really the world was getting to know the character and his villains and the supporting cast.
Outside the comics. Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And the storylines were really engaging. They really had heart behind them. And they really dealt with some of Barry Allen's personal dramas as well. Mm-hmm. So it was really not just focused on the superhero. And it wasn't like, I would say the Hulk, you could watch any episode and understand what's going on. The Flash really built on previous episodes and his relationship with the people around him and with the city as a whole.
Yeah, which is kind of unusual for the time period.
Yeah, it really was. So this, it was groundbreaking. It really was. And I watched every episode when it was on, when it aired.
Mm-hmm.
So let's talk about the reception. How did people like it? The 1990 Flash TV series was generally well received, but audience and critics at the time. It was praised for its special effects mostly.
Mm-hmm.
Action sequences and John Wesley Shipp's performance as Barry Allen and as the Flash. But it was way too costly to keep going on. Because of the special effects, production costs were really, really high. And the ratings just weren't there. So ultimately, CBS canceled the show after one season. But despite its short run, it has had a lasting impact on the superhero genre. John Wesley Shipp, who played The Flash in the 1990 series, has made appearances in later TV adaptations of The Flash. He appears on the 2014 Flash TV series. He portrays Barry Allen's father now, Henry Allen, which was an awesome nod back to the 1990 series.
Mm-hmm.
Again, I don't think there is a 2014 series without the 1990s Flash series. It had proven that it could be successful and it could be received by a larger audience.
I would go so far as to say we don't have as much superhero media without the 89 Batman and the 1990 Flash.
Yeah.
Both kind of coming out at the same time.
Yeah, it's important to note that the 90 Flash built on the 89 Batman. It's DC's next thing that they licensed out.
Yeah, and that kicked off like Lois and Clark, and then it kicked off a bunch of other things that came, and that kept the superhero genre becoming more and more popular.
Because we really went for a space in the 80s where we didn't have any...
No, there was nothing.
Small screen, big screen, we had nothing.
Nothing,
yeah. And Batman hits in 89.
Yeah.
Before Batman, what did we have? Superman 4. Batman hits in 89, and then we get The Flash. And then we really start to get more and more licensed properties out there.
Mm-hmm.
Blade, X-Men.
Blade was really the... Blade was
stuff that
really accelerated everything, too.
The Flash TV series was successful. It costs way too much.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The 1990 Flash TV series holds a special place in hearts of fans, especially my own, who grew up watching Barry Allen's adventures unfold on the screens. It really was my first introduction to a live-action version of him.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, I was a huge Super Friends fan, but he wasn't as big a role as I'd like him to be. This series laid the foundation for future adaptations and showcased the enduring appeal of the Scarlet Speedster. So whether you're a fan of the modern Flash or just curious about the superhero television landscape of the 1990s, take a trip down memory lane and give the 1990 Flash series a watch. You can get it on, I believe it's on streaming. I have it on DVD.
It's on Max, right?
I believe it's on Max.
I think it's on Max.
You truly won't be disappointed. John Wesley Shipp really took a character and made it his own. And if you ever get a chance to go to a convention and meet him, do it. Really genuinely nice guy.
I'm going to watch it. I'm going to give it a try again.
There you go. Brian's going to watch it.
Give it a
Maybe
shot,
we'll follow this up with Brian's opinion on the Flash series. Thanks for watching. Love what you collect.
Collect what you love.
We'll see you next time.